The Girod Street Cemetery was located in central New Orleans in Louisiana. It was established around 1822 and lasted up until about 1940. Now, it was a Protestant cemetery, so it was technically considered to be a minority. And like most cemeteries in Louisiana, it was an above-ground cemetery. It consisted of mausoleums and other above-ground tombs. At its height, it had 2,300 mausoleum entombments, along with another 1,100 assorted above-ground burials. But it was always getting a bad rap, mainly because nobody really wanted to take care of it. During the many pandemics of the 19th century, bodies were simply just being thrown at the gateway for burial. The crypts were so poorly constructed that there were many complaints of the smell of decomposition and other nasty things. By about 1880, the mayor of New Orleans had made a suggestion that the cemetery be demolished. These words, unfortunately, fell on deaf ears. Nobody wanted to touch it. Not even the owners, Christ Church. They did attempt in the latter part of the 19th century and again in the early 20th century to try and gussy the place up. But by then, most people didn't want to bury their loved ones there or entomb their loved ones there. They were taking them to better maintained places. Who'd blame them? I wouldn't. By about 1957, the cemetery was actually deconsecrated. And it was announced that all burials that were left in the cemetery had to be removed because what was left of it had been sold for a sum of $300,000. Now, in these photographs, you're going to see a number of burial containers literally pulled out of the niches in the mausoleum. Now, that's not grave robbing, okay? That was when they were removing the remains of deceased before the cemetery was to be demolished. What they would do was, most of these burial containers were made of cast iron. You're going to see a couple of containers that were known as Fisk body container, burial containers, I should say. And what they did was they just smashed them open, removed the remains, and took them to wherever they were to be reburied. Now, there were two cemeteries that received the remains of the Girard Street Cemetery. And unfortunately, even in death, there was racial segregation. You just can't win, can you? But anyway, take a look at some of these photographs. They're quite stunning. What happened to the cemetery? I'll tell you at the end. Isn't that just incredible? And also so sad. I mean, when you lay someone to rest, you think that's going to be their perpetual resting place, and sometimes it just isn't. So what happened to the cemetery when it was eventually demolished? It became the parking lot of the Superdome. That's right. The parking lot. So, if you ever get to go down there and you go to the Superdome, don't forget what used to be there. The Girod Street Cemetery. And until our next cemetery adventure, this is Sharon saying, be respectful, take only pictures, and leave only footprints. Bye for now.